Hola, estudiantes. Hi, students. I'm going to be talking to you about this class, Spanish 601D. This class is offered by our the Spanish and Portuguese department, and then we call it Spanish first year, Spanish 1. In this class, let me tell you that you're going to learn a lot. And I know that because we have received feedback from students telling me and telling other instructors, wow, in this class, we have learned more than we have learned taking Spanish 3 years in high school. So that's good, students. Let me talk about vocabulary. In this class, you're going to learn a wide range of vocabulary that you're going to be using in real situations. You're going to be learning about family, about clothes, about sports and food. Also, you're going to be learning grammar. You're going to learn and practice grammar, so you're going to be able to speak in the present. How can I speak Spanish using the present? The activities that we usually do in Spanish in the present. You're going also to be able to speak about the future. What are your plans in the future? What are the activities you're going to do in the near future? So you're going to learn about the future in this class. And also you're going to be learning about the past. What are the activities that you already done, they're completed, they finished, yet that you did it in the past, maybe last year, maybe last week. So also you're going to be learning the difference between imperfect and pretérito. And it's very interesting to know how we use that in Spanish. Another component that is very important in our classes is conversation. You will learn skills to develop communicative proficiency in Spanish. And then at the beginning of the semester, you're going to learn basic phrases on how to communicate with your classmates, how to communicate with your instructors. Phrases like, ¿cómo se dice table en español? ¿Cómo se escribe table en español? And basic phrases. As the semester progresses, you're going to be learning more expressions. Expressions like how to make a request, how to invite someone to have coffee, to have tea, to maybe go to the movie theater, how to express your positive and negative feelings. Also, you're going to be learning phrases on how to request, to give or refuse and refuse help. So those are phrases, very important phrases that are going to let students to be able to communicate that in Spanish using those phrases. And our students tend to use these expressions in our classes to improve the communication. Okay, and then estudiantes, we have more activities in our classes. We have one activity, one of the activities I want to talk to you is the hablar activity. These hablar activities, students prepare a few questions at home. They come to class, they get together with a classmate or a group of classmates, and they start talking just in Spanish. They start having a conversation in Spanish. There a question and then an answer, then they get comfortable, and then there's talk and talk more in Spanish. Every two chapters, we have these hablar activities in our classroom. So students, at the beginning, they're shy and they don't want to talk. But once they complete the first one, they say, oh, I like that activity. And then they really like this activity. Sometimes we have just to finish with that assignment and they want to keep going and to keep practicing and talking in Spanish. So, and this is a good practice that they do during the semester. Because at the end of the semester, they have another activity, and we call this one talk abroad activity. This is an online conversation that students will have with a Spanish a native speaker, Spanish native speaker, and then they will have a conversation for 30 minutes. There is a pre-assignment. In this pre-assignment, the students need to prepare for the conversation. Once they have ready, they're prepared, then they have to schedule the appointment and talk with these people. And then there is a post-assignment. In this activity that they do after the conversation, they have a series of questions they have to answer, and they realize what are the weak areas that they need to be working more, or what are the strong areas. So this is a good reflection on how they're doing at the end of the semester. Okay, and we have the last one that I'm going to be talking here with you, to you, is the creative project. In this activity, what we want is a student create something. Create something, and everything has to be in Spanish. So students are able to create a song, and they can perform the song. One semester, my students perform a song. They create the song, they write the song, and then perform the song. It was amazing. Because once they have the project ready, they have like a month to work in that project. Once the project is ready, they have to present that to the classmates. And then the students can create a board game, a physical board game, or a online game. Sometimes they use Google Slides to create a game on how to practice maybe vocabulary in Spanish, how to practice the conjugations in Spanish, or they can present a skit, or they can present something for the classmates. And then this is also a very, very, very nice activity. We have very talented students. And I want to show you now some of the assignments that our students have presented. This is about food. And it is really, really pretty. And you see, they create that. We have very talented students like this. They ask a question to the classmates, like, por ejemplo, ¿qué te gusta comer? ¿La pizza o el queso? If the student decides pizza is what he likes to eat, then they have to place right here the pizza. If they say, oh, no, me gusta comer queso. Oh, muy bien. Entonces, vamos, te gusta comer queso. ¿De acuerdo? Y entonces, este es uno de los, this is one of the projects. I have another one. These are the ones I have available here, and this is about sports. And then, they call Las Aventuras de Sebastián. And they're talking about this guy that went to the Olympics. So they're describing what happened and what everything he went through when he got to the Olympics. And I have one more, and this is about the professions. This is also really, really nice. And then here, students need to decide the clothes. They're talking about firefighters. And then the students that are presenting the project ask classmates, okay, ¿Cuál es la ropa que lleva un bombero? Bueno, un bombero lleva una chaqueta y lleva unos pantalones. So these are some of the assignments that we have received from students. And then, I hope this is good for you. You have an idea how what are the topics that we cover in this class, Spanish 601. And I hope to see you soon in our classes. Hasta luego, hasta pronto.